Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here. It's 9 a.m. on the East Coast, and stock index futures are flat in the pre-market this morning. Big down day yesterday. Bank of America down over 2%. So big down day there. We're back on a sell signal, trying to hold support at 1680. If that breaks, look for move down to 1602. We need to close on Wednesday above 1714 to give us a new buy signal. I wouldn't be interested in taking that if it were to show up on Wednesday. Looking at Petrobras, big pop on Monday, fall through to the upside on Tuesday. A nice big open gap below, and we actually leaped over an open gap here. So quite a bit of enthusiasm from Monday's big pop. We need to close below 1467 to give us a sell signal on Wednesday. Don't think that's going to happen. Ford Motor continues to slide, holding support at 1406. If that breaks, look for a move down to 1328. We need to close on Wednesday above 1541 to give us a buy signal. Not expecting that to happen. Valet's been on a pop for the last couple of days. There's an open gap there, which is potentially going to act as resistance. We're looking for a close above 1141. Didn't get that yesterday. Closed at 1139, so 2 cents away from a buy signal for Valet. Looking at General Electric, we've been moving down over the last couple of weeks, down at the bottom of the panic zones, trying to hold the July low. If that breaks, then look for a move down to 24.22. On the upside, we need a close on Wednesday above 25.63 to give us a buy signal. Not expecting that to happen. Alcoa is our next stock. It's had a nice move off support at 14.84, right in the middle of the range from the recent high to the recent low. We still need to close on Wednesday above 1609 to give us a buy signal for Alcoa. Looking at Twitter, we're trying to get to 56.25, not able to do it so far. A close below 51.27 would give us a sell signal on Wednesday for Twitter. For General Motors, big reversal. We were on a buy signal for 2 days and then down hard yesterday. We need to close above 33.49 to give us a buy signal on Wednesday. Not expecting that to happen. And so looking to see if last week's lows will hold for General Motors. Looking at Coca-Cola, we're pushing through the top of the panic zones there. So we've seen some panic buying recently. We're trading above 43.75. Look two lines up. 45.31 should be our next target to the upside if we're going to keep going here. On the downside, we'd be sellers with a close below 42.29 on Wednesday. Not expecting that to happen. And of course, that lower channel line will continue to rise daily. Pfizer's our next stock and still trading off the top of the panic zones. Early warning signal went off. Chart turned red. We're heading lower, still projecting lower prices here. Looking for a move down to retest the August lows down there at 28.13. The lows, of course, were slightly below that, but 28.13 is our mathematical target to the downside. On the upside, and we do have an open gap to get through there, we need to close on Wednesday above 29.71, and of course that upper channel line will continue to decline daily. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Have a great day, and we'll be back tomorrow morning with today's stock market and a look at the TSX 10 most actively traded stocks.